I just asked the governor, what is the difference between a Tennessee welcome and any other kind? And he reassured me that it was warmer, whatever that is. Anyway, thank you, Greg, and good afternoon to you all. I wish everybody in this room and elsewhere a happy Father's Day to all the dads who happen to be here today. It's my pleasure to bring you greetings from everyone from the Fiat Chrysler world on what is a pretty significant occasion for Magneti Marelli and this community. I want to thank in particular the governor, Bill Haslam, who has honored us with his presence today, and I want to thank Senator Alexander, Congressman Blackburn, Mayor Ford. We need to work on your last name, Mayor. I had to use every ounce of self-control to pronounce the name. But Mayor Ford, soon to be changed to something acceptable, and Commissioner Haggerty for their support. And I'm delighted that each one of you could be here today to join us for this celebration. As I said, the day is significant because it marks the successful completion of an ambitious project, as well as the beginning of a new beginning and a new life for this plant, which started its life as a shock absorber site. We all know that just a few years ago, this plant and very many automotive plants in this country went through a very difficult time due to the global crisis of the automotive sector. But I think we've been able to find the strength to stand and fight, and eventually all of us have been able to reverse our fate. The plant that you see today has been completely rebuilt, re-engineered, and it's been turned into a cutting-edge industrial facility equipped with our best technologies. And we've put in place production processes that apply the same world-class manufacturing principles that have been adopted across the whole Fiat Chrysler world. These are the best standards in the world for eliminating waste in all types of forms, and they help improve safety, efficiency, and quality while reducing the environmental impact of our industrial actions. And I mentioned this to the governor earlier, but the decision to create a new plant dedicated to the automotive lighting business here in Pulaski was approved on June 6th of 2012, after somewhat of a lengthy process. But with truly unprecedented speed, just 1 year and 10 days later, the project is real and it's running and it's ready to become even bigger. What has been achieved here demonstrates a strong commitment and a sense of purpose that everyone that was involved in this project devoted to the project itself and devoted to the prospect of generating growth and prosperity for the area. And I have to say that this would not have been possible, and I think we need to be absolutely clear about this, that we would not have been possible without the support of the state of Tennessee. And I'd like to publicly thank the governor and his team for believing in us and in this project from the very beginning and for helping us make it a reality. Now, just a handful of facts and figures are needed to illustrate the importance of this plant. We've invested about $54 million. We're going to invest about $54 million by the time the project is complete. Installed production capacity is currently 2.5 million lamps a year, but we've already planned to double that capacity to 5 million at the latest by 2016. And this is going to create hundreds of jobs. By the end of this year, around 150 people are going to be added to the 90 that already work here, and within hopefully 3 and maximum 4 years of the total new jobs in this plant would be close to 850. So these numbers are the measure by how much we believe in the state, in the city, and in the community. I want to share with you the reasons why we decided to bet on this plant and build a brand new production site here. Automotive lighting represents the first and most important of the 8 different areas of Magneti Marelli portfolio, by itself accounting for more than 1/3 of the revenues of the business. It is today one of the leading players in the automotive lighting at the global level, with more than 100 years of growth that's been built on its ability to bring innovation and technological excellence to its customers. The plant and the investment we decided to make here reflect our ambitions to grow even more in our future. And in the North American market, we are unfortunately just 3rd. But with the strength and the advanced technology provided by this production site, we will be in a much more competitive position. So now there's absolutely no reason why automotive lighting here for Magnelli Marelli cannot achieve the number one spot. Pulaski, as I've been reminded, is in a strategic location. It's close to many of our customers and some of Fiat Chrysler's competitors, opening up more room for future expansion. But the main reason that we chose to invest in our project here speaks to our people and their values. We were looking for skilled and motivated people, passionate and determined people, people who embrace the culture of doing things and doing them well. And so we found all these qualities here. And what I can assure you is that Magneti Marelli is part of the wider Fiat Chrysler family, which includes about 215,000 people worldwide. Is an enterprise that thinks globally, but in each region and in each community in which it functions, it behaves as if it were a local business. And it's not simply a matter of adapting our products to the specific demands of each market, but for us, being local is more than anything a way of living and of growing with the culture of the community where we're present, sharing the challenges and the successes, feeling part of its history and even more of its future. It's a commitment to the people that work with us and to the communities where we've established and developed an industrial presence. The need to achieve the best international standard of competitiveness wherever it is that we operate is not up for discussion. But that requirement is also accompanied by a responsibility toward each one of the communities where we operate. It's an approach that's based on respect for the local culture, willingness to integrate in the local community, playing an active role in generating jobs and contributing to its progress and its well-being. And this is what we're doing here in Pulaski, and we're proud to do so. I'm going to conclude by thanking everyone who has worked on this project, beginning with the employees mainly here of Pulaski, who are already producing the first lamps for strategic products such as the new Jeep Cherokee. One of the reasons for holding the ceremony at the plant today is that it was a very fitting way to give the workers here the recognition they deserve and to thank them for their commitment and the quality of their work. I'd like to thank again the state of Tennessee for the state support that it's given in this extraordinary venture, and it's a great privilege for Magneti Marelli and Fiat Chrysler as well to be able to participate in the future growth and development of the Pulaski area and the Tennessee automotive industry. Thank you all for coming.